Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. Well, I say Photoshop, but we're not actually in Photoshop at the moment. We're on the internet. We're on the wonderful Flickr website. And here's one of my pictures from a photo stream. Now, it's not exactly a brilliant picture. In fact, what is it? In fact, what it is part of a hidden mosaic, a mosaic that you can only find if you know where to look. I've actually made a whole set of images. Have a click on the set, and you'll see the mosaic becomes revealed. There you go. So there's the mosaic of Stonehenge, and underneath it I've got another mosaic of a castle in Kent. Now, each of these images is one single photograph, but I didn't photograph them all individually. I used Photoshop to get everything together, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment. But for now, just look at the top here. Notice I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 images across. That's the way that Flickr works. When you have a set of images, you can only ever have 6 across and up to 10 deep. And each of these is a perfect square. So if we get our images and chop them up into perfect squares, 6 across and however many down, we can hide them as a mosaic in a set. Okay, I'm going to show you how it's done. Back over to Photoshop. Here we go. So first of all, we've got to get our image just the right size. So we're going to grab the crop tool and we're going to put some specific dimensions in here. 3000 pixels on the width and 1000 pixels on the height. Now, I've got a panoramic image here, so 1000 is fine, but for perhaps normal shaped images, you might want to use 2000 or 2500 pixels. You'll see how these numbers pan out in a minute. Okay, let's crop that down like so. I'm going to lose a little bit top or bottom. That's just the way it is, but nothing too important. Right, so my image is cropped. So I now need to make lots of very small pictures out of this image. And I'm going to do that by using a selection. So I'm going to get the selection tool, I'm going to make sure I've got feathering set to 0, and I'm going to change the style to fixed size. Okay, let's put a size in here of 500 px for pixels, and a height of 500 px for pixels. So that should ensure a perfect square. Now, let's go in nice and tight on the top of the photograph here so we can see what's happening. Lovely. And with one click of the selection tool, I'll make a selection that's exactly 500 pixels square. So I don't have to worry about sizes or anything like that. Okay, we can cut this out, edit and cut, and then go to file and make a new document. Now it'll be the exact size of the image you just cut. So click OK and back to edit and paste it in. And there we are. That's going to be our first picture and the first part of our photo stream mosaic. Right, back to our main picture, and we'll start chopping other bits up as well. So again, with one click of the mouse, I'll get a perfectly sized selection, just like that. And we'll cut that out, edit and cut. Better still is Control and X, or Command X on a Mac, and Command V or Control V on a PC to paste. And that'll just speed things up a little bit. Okay, so we'll move along like so. Now, if you've done your maths, you'll realize that the reason we set this to 3000 pixels in width and 500 pixels for each of these squares is because that will give you 6 images across. So let's keep going. Okay, now I'm just going to speed things up a little bit and just try and do this faster using the magic of video. Okay, so here we are, last one, just at finish, cut that one out, paste it in. Okay, so there we go. So I've now got all of my images together, and each one you'll notice is on its own separate layer. So we've chopped our image up into little squares, like so, 6 squares across and 2 down, because it's quite a thin image. And that's going to make our hidden mosaic. And to be honest, that only took about 3 minutes in the real world, so it wasn't that long. But now we've got to save each of these layers as an individual picture. But fortunately, there's a nice little shortcut for doing that. Come over to File, down to Scripts, and you'll find a script called Export Layers to File. Click on that and choose where you'd like to save your pictures. I've already got a folder set up. And give it a prefix name. I'm going to call these mosaic number 3 because it's the third one. Use the JPEG setting and the quality I'm going to leave as 10 and click run. Now Photoshop is now going to go through each and every layer and turn each layer into an individual picture. And we're done. Okay, so fantastic. It's done that. It said it's exported successfully. And here's the images saved. You can see most of them there, but they are all there, trust me. Okay, so let's get these images uploaded onto Flickr and start playing around with the sets to create our hidden mosaic. So here we are back in Flickr, and as you can see, I've uploaded the pictures that we just sort of cut and paste into little squares earlier, so each one's its own separate photograph. Right, let's click on the Organize button. And I'm going to organize these images within a set. So I've already made a set of other photo mosaics, so I'm going to add it into that one. But you may need to make your own set, of course. So here we go. These are the ones I've already got. And it can be quite tricky to work out what's going on here because it doesn't display them on the organizer in the same way as it does inside of the set page. But not to worry, we'll figure this out. Right, so here's the individual pictures along the bottom. They may be in order, and looking at these, amazingly, and for the first time ever, they actually are. It doesn't always work out that way. So I can just grab all of those and drop them at the beginning, so I'd like them to appear at the top, the newest ones at the top, like so. Now, have a quick check just to make sure these are in order. If you're never completely sure, and sometimes it can be hard to work out, simply double-click it, and it will tell you the name, so hopefully you can get that to be in the right order. But once you're happy with the order, click on the Save button. That'll save your set. Go back to your photo stream and check that it works by having a look at the set as everybody else would see it. And there you go. Look at that. There it is. So there's a brand new mosaic set. Little hidden pictures. And remember, each of these is actually a real image and can be clicked on. So there you go. There's how you can hide a wonderful photo mosaic inside of Flickr using Photoshop.